interesting state that people ask that, of course, reading about the past and reading about the future and the parihas. But one comment which I recurrently came across the people when this issue came, that, okay, I said, this is not for me as a person from science or computers. It is, first thing is absolutely amazing that I can find the name. They can find, Nari can tell me my name, my father's name, my mother's name, my age, my date of birth, my this one or the other, or about my, or the names of my children. This is very difficult. Rather, I would say my daughter's name is Sahita, and my son's name is Nachiketas, and others, the youngest one is Tejasa. Now, I did some research on that, and I found that how many combinations are possible. Later on, of course, I wanted to know whether rishis have told this only for India, or only for Hindus, or only for this one. And then I started, as I came to know one, I saw your book, and I got introduced to you, and you gave me your book. And then my curiosity went on, really, exponentially increasing. I wanted to know about it, and I wanted to do some systematic research on this. I was not interested in more of the future or the past. I was interested in one computational aspect of this. How can you find that whole, suppose we are there, and I have a book already written on me, which has 12 chapters, which can talk about the whole of my life. So there are, how many books there could be? There are 7 billion people today on the earth. So 7 billion people on this earth in which my story is written. So this is like a language of God, is like given to me. No, these things. In that case, what are the combinations possible? I discovered recently, I did a combination mathematically, and I found that this combinations in that context, only in this context, blow up to what is called exa. 1 million, 1,000 million is 1 billion, 1,000 billion is 1 trillion, 1,000 trillion is 1 petya, and 1,000 petya is 1 exa. In that level of computation are required to find my name. So, they say the supercomputers of the future, which I will come after 10 years. If they have to do, of course it cannot be done. It is an unsolvable problem mathematically. It's an unsolvable problem mathematically. It's called NP complete problem. So if somebody can find my name, then my name and about this, all this correctly, then I just bow before that. It's beyond computation. What am I coming from supercomputer? This one, first experience. Leave apart whether this is other aspect of it and then waiver things and all those things about telling about a future and a past. So this has amazed me as a computer scientist, as a supercomputer science, one work in mathematics. Then of course I wanted to really find out, because that does it apply only to Hindus. Then I started sending people from, somebody just visiting me from Germany, somebody was visiting from Africa, somebody coming from the Gulf, from whether it applies only to Hindus or Muslims, and the experience which you have shown me, the people from Aurangabad, the Muslim family and this one. So it's amazing. It is not that just applied to them. This is for the whole world.
Yeah.
And that shows that our culture, which was right from the beginning, is a universal culture. It's applied to the entire world. There are many statements of this kind. Ours is a universal philosophy and universal culture. So this also corroborated to find out that we rishis did not think both the religion, dharma, the concept of dharma, our concept of philosophy is really a world encompassing. This proved that actually proved it, that it is not this and the references come, Vasudeva Kutumbakam, come, the Vedic thing is that prayers are for the universal prayers. So this is another proof that this really happened. This one. Then another thing which came very surprising, how it talks about the current technology.
So,
for example, in another Nani Shastra, we came to the Dhanukar colony. When I just had, I had gone there for different context. And at that time came that my son is studying something like in computational, not engineering, but something very close to computers, something like that. Engineering, which I was studying there at that time. I said, how? At that time when I go, Nari talks about that. Later on, when he went out to the US, actually, we had some problems of visa because I think they had questioned that I had questioned Americans. American talks, American stars on
supercomputers. Your friendship with Americans is well known.
So I had some problems with the whole family.
Yes.
Where, and then he wanted to go for studies there, and of course I also had a 10-year visa, and earlier that was cancelled. Not cancelled, something like that.
So
then he, of course, the Nadis came that he will go there, and he actually went there. He got a special dispensation and he went there. Then he came back.
So
then when I go next time for reading something in a different context, it comes now that he has completed engineering, he has gone there, and he comes back. Means how? Of course, all of you experience this. All of it is in the time constant. Now, how this ancient leaf like this, which is might have written several hundred centuries back, we can date it, but it looks like it's several centuries back. How it is written now, how it comes, that in this today's context, I'm reading it. And it changes. I read, of course, you must have read many times. I read several times. You, of course, read. In that context, in that thing, it comes context and the time. How this is written, this is a main mystery for any science.
So,
how this is scribed on this leaf in that context and talking today's language. One of my greatest experience was Sakya Maharaj. Guruvari Sakya Maharaj, who is my teacher of Narishwari, which I can never forget.
So
that I remember he had a car accident in 2003, and one day at night I got a call, early morning I got a call that Maharaj is concerned and he's lying. He's almost unconscious, and his closest disciple has passed away in the accident already. Passed away. So I left in early morning, and then of course he was unconscious, and then doctors were treating Lokmanya Hospital, the trauma hospital. There, Lokmanya in Pimpri, I think. Then I went, and of course there was no. And in the whole process, he was a ventilator. In the whole process, he got some infection. He got into meningitis. And doctors had at that time given the hope, and he was unconscious almost like so many days. At that time I was about to travel to South Africa, leading the Indian delegation on supercomputing. And I didn't know what to do. So I said that we're trying all kind of things. So I said, suddenly I remembered what you told us.
So
I remembered that why not we read Nadi now?
Mm-hmm.
And I told him, because I did not remember until then, and I called the family members, go and read the Nadi. Because Maharaj was unconscious, we took some impressions from this one, and we went to the Dangichok,
yes,
this one, the center.
Yes.
And then they were trying to search and this one. First time when they went, I think the Zambi pressures were not clear enough. Next time they were taken. And as soon as the Nadi is open, and Nadi was found, the leaf was found, and it came like that this Jataka was coming. So Parvati is asking Shankara, and Shankara is telling that now who is coming. He is lying unconscious. Okay, first I lie. He is lying unconscious, and everybody is concerned. And now all the rishis are present to hear what is going to happen to this great man, to this person. Then they said that we will not read further. The family members have to do a puja. They should go and do the Shiva puja, in the place which is where he is staying. That is one which came. And the sons should do it, the eldest sons should do it. The second game is that he has to do the Mahabhutinjaya Yajna. But this Yajna should be done by 11 people who are elder to him.
Mm-hmm.
And it should be done in a absolutely in a traditional Vedic manner. So we planned, I think I was going there and he said, and the message which I gave as I was boarding the aircraft. A message came to me, and I was about in the airport, because I was traveling to Pretoria. A message came to me that it's not, we are not finding.
So,
they are not finding people, 11 people who are able to. So they are, some of them there, but they are not able to get up, and they're like, Maharaj was at that time 67 or 65 or something like that. Then suddenly I remember Pandit Vasundhara Mahadi. That I know Prasanna Pandit Vasundhara Mahadi, perhaps he knows these people. I said, I phone Panditji, that somehow you find 11 people. He said, I know in Pune itself.
Mm.
They went to Nashi, they went to Kalandi, they tried to this one, they could not get it. But safe. And then I, of course, landed in South Africa, and I learned that they could find, and they had Mahamrityunjaya Yajna, that they called Pandits from Varanasi. and they conducted that. Absolutely. Then they, after doing that, they again went for readings. He said that, then the Rishi, this Nadi said, that after some 40 days, 45 days, Maharaj will come to consciousness.